one in 1,000 children are born deaf every year, and that number just steadily increases through time. And if you live long enough, right, which we all hope to do, and you're pretty much guaranteed that you're going to have some sort of hearing loss, and it's often pretty significant, right? So this is a really significant problem. We take our sense of hearing when it's working right, we take it almost instinctively, right? But it's absolutely essential, not for our well-being, but I think maybe even more importantly, our sense of connectedness with one another. We're very good now at recognizing this. All newborns in the Netherlands and most developed countries have their hearing screened from right at birth, because it's recognized that these early interventions are important to acquire language and acquire that sense of connectedness. We're getting a little bit better at diagnosing hearing impairment in the elderly, because we recognize it improves that well-being by improving that sort of sense of connectedness. And so the work in my lab really focuses, just as you said, on a small part of the auditory system. So it turns out that most forms of hearing impairment actually are some dysfunction in the inner ear, specific part of the ear, and in fact the sensory cells that are important for transducing sound, right, which is just a mechanical stimulus, right, into a biological signal. Most forms of hearing impairment are coming about because of some dysfunction of those cells in the inner ear and their connections then to the rest of the brain. So that's where our research is focused on those cells, right, and the molecules that they express, the proteins that they express that underlie their function, with a big motivation being, well, I'll be honest, just to understand sort of this beautifully elegant biological system, but also with the idea that there's going to be a lot of practical results from this work.